Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm so happy to meet you all today on New Year's Eve. New Year's Eve or Sylvester? If you're having a hard time finding a party to celebrate New Year's Eve, maybe you are searching with the wrong word here in Germany. Here in Munich, in Germany, they say Sylvester. Sylvester, like most things in Munich, has religious roots. Saint Sylvester was noted reforming a Gregorian calendar, which has had a 31st of December as the last day of the year in the calendar. So it felt like a perfect fit to name the last day of the year after him, Sylvester. If you want to wish someone Happy New Year in German, you say Guten Rutsch. In a loose translation into English, it means have a good slide into a new year. However, it has a Yiddish roots. A word Rutsch means the beginning. You can also simply say Happy New Year as Frohes Neues Jahr. Let's talk about the New Year traditions in Uzbekistan and Germany. New Year is widely celebrated in Uzbekistan due to Soviet traditions, when the New Year was a big holiday and not Christmas. We do decorate a Christmas tree and we also exchange with the presents, but everything happens on New Year's Eve, which is 31st. Traditionally, people don't visit others, don't go out. They prefer sitting at home and celebrating New Year Eve in a family atmosphere. One thing special I can say that for the New Year Eve, we prepare from the morning a lot of dishes and then we get on the 1st of January the breakfast, like a royal breakfast. We don't have any specific dish that we prepare, but we do have one salad, which is a salad Olivier, and that's kind of a must in every household. They prepare that salad on New Year's Eve. Similar traditions between the Uzbekistan and German New Year's Eve tradition is to watch a movie which is famous. In my country, we watch the movie Slokka Parom, which is a Russian production from Soviet time. It's basically adventure of a guy who gets drunk and misses his flight and ends up being in the same in the different city, in the same flat, in the same address, but not at his house where the lady lives. So they get to know each other. So it's kind of fun, and we watch with our family that melodrama. Here in Germany, no one knows why the Germans are obsessed of watching the 1963 short British comedic film called Dinner for One, which talks about the 19th birthday of a lady, Dinner for One, on a New Year Eve, yet the tradition remains widely popular. Another similarity on the New Year's Eve between Uzbekistan and Germany is both countries use fireworks in the New Year's Eve. But the things are changing in Germany due to the environmental concerns. From 2019, Munich has adopted limitations to the firework and they are banning private fireworks. Only the government can organize, only the cities and states can organize the firework, but not the private people. Because I remember coming to work early in the morning on the 1st of January, and when I used to walk through the city and passing by from the clubs, it looked like a battlefield, and the smell stays during the night because people celebrate till the morning, till the early morning, and it's just a very bad thing for the environment. It scares the animals, it scares the children, it is bad for the pregnant woman, for the people with asthma. So the country and the city is taking a measurements towards that. If anybody uses the firework without allowance of the government, then they have to pay a fine, which is 50,000 euros or 3 years of jail. I understand that the people would like to enjoy the holidays, but we have to also think about the environment. And I personally like this kind of strict measurements to stop air pollution in the big cities like Munich. Today is the New Year's Eve. New Year is the most joyful holiday, which gives hope and faith in a miracles. This gives us an expectation that the coming year will be definitely better than the previous one. On this positive note, I wish you all a frohes neues Jahr. Ciao.